Happy Halloween, all you little jerks. Dre here, and today we're in a super spooky, totally accurate battle simulator. Yes, this is the game that keeps on giving. We had a faction update a week ago, and now there's actually a whole new spooky faction in Totally Accurate Battle Simulator. We have 7 new units, 2 new maps. Well, technically, they're refurnished versions of older maps, but still, they're really cool. A whole new spooky campaign just for a quick Halloween update. That's why I love Landfall Games. They know how to treat the holidays right. So yeah, we're going to check out this new faction today. We are starting off with the Skeleton Warriors here. There's actually a bunch of new units here. 7, like I said, to be specific. We got the Archers, the Candleheads, the Vampires, the Pumpkin Catapults, the Swordcaster, and the Very Deadly Reaper. I actually have no idea if it's deadly or not, but I'm assuming it is. It's a freaking Reaper. So yeah, as per usual, and there's a new faction that comes out, we're going to test these guys. Let's test these guys against... Let's go for Farmers. All right, so it's 19 versus 13. I have no idea what the Skeleton Archers do. We're in the Warriors right now. But I have no idea what the Skeletons do. I hope they reanimate themselves. That would be really, really cool. It is a Skeleton after all. Ooh, what is that? Okay, so they didn't last long at all. I mean, they are Skeletons after all, but they're putting some sort of debuff. Oh, he's running away. They're scared. Okay, so this is a good unit for pushing back units. It doesn't look like they're very strong at all. I don't think they stood a chance at all. Let's drop these guys down a little bit, because I want to see how this new debuff works. I'm assuming it just scares them away. So yes, be scared. Okay, yeah, they're literally running away. Do they run off the map? That's the bigger question here. And yes, they indeed do. All right, next up, we got the Skeleton Archers. Looks like they shoot flaming arrows? I put them up against the squares because I wanted to give them a good chance here. Oh my god, do they actually ignite? This is so cool. Look at this guy. Where'd your neck go, my dude? Okay, I'm too focused on that. These guys are actually on fire. Does the fire spread between units? It doesn't look like it does, but this is by far one of the coolest archer units yet. I mean, they're shooting fire right now, and these guys are not even going to get in range, I don't think. Maybe one of them? Yes, he got a hit in at least, but obviously this was made for these guys to win. That is really, really cool. Now I want to try this against a large unit to see how much damage this thing's actually doing. Let's try some cheerleaders as well, just to see if they do anything unique. And no, it just looks like they shoot a little bit faster, obviously. This guy... I think I underestimate the Ice Giant, because he could take a lot of damage. God, all right, damn. And the next unit on the list is good old Candlehead. Now, I have no idea what this unit could possibly do. I'm assuming it shoots fire or something like that. But a very unique-looking unit for Halloween. I never expected to see Candlehead. So we have a couple Brawlers over here to fight against these guys. I feel like they might need the defense here. Again, I have no idea what these guys do, though, so we're going to find out pretty quickly here. I thought they'd be a ranged unit. Okay, they are a ranged unit, and they are... Did not expect that. Is that freezing? What the hell? That is so cool. What does that have to do with candles, though? Okay, so it's shooting, like, orbs that push these guys back, as well as freeze them, I think? I think that's the effect that's going on. This unit is extremely good, though. Man, what are we gonna put up against these guys? Okay, there you go. You guys are all cheered up. Let's see if he can take out a few kings here. The pushback, these guys are obviously much heavier, but the pushback is still working. So I think this unit against melee units would be pretty much... Never mind. He's still getting hit. I was going to say he's going to be pretty much unstoppable because of the pushback, but clearly it's not a pushback effect that's hard enough against the kings. All right, and moving on to the next unit, we have the Vampire. Look at these little derpy bats. I love that they turn into bats. That's so good. So obviously a very fast unit, not the most majestic of landing. Vampires clearly aren't very good at that. Let's actually try and use one of these units, because I want to see... Yes, they're obviously sucking blood. Okay, I you know what? I'm not even going to try and control this guy. Because that was all over the place. But yes, they obviously try and pounce on the guys and suck their blood. Now the question is, do they heal with that? Or is it just taking out the life force? And it's very hard to tell because these guys go crouch on the ground whenever they attack. Yeah, this is kind of a mess right now. Let's see. Come on. Suck them. I'm hitting them for sure, and I wasn't healing. So I think it just depletes their health. Still, we got another unit with a totally new mechanic. It turns into bats and then sucks the blood of the enemies. That is so cool. Oh, God. This is so sick. All right. It's looking like a closer fight this time. This guy's on the ground sucking the blood of his enemies, but the blue team wins that time. All right. We got the super spoopy pumpkin cannon. Look at the skeleton on the back. I want to see, is this just an ordinary cannon? This thing's got to explode. It's lighting up. That's telling me that I think this might be an explosive. Yes! Okay, I don't know if that's any different from the actual cannon, because I know, or sorry, the catapult, because I know it does do a little bit of a blast radius, so it might just be a reskin of the cannon, or it might have a unique feature as well. Come on, shoot, buddy. The reload time of this pumpkin is ridiculous, but man, the damage output's pretty aggressive. Oh, can we survive it? No, you cannot. So yeah, that's the pumpkin cannon. You know what? Let's boost that thing just for fun. And now we should make quick work of this team here. There we go. Oh, dude, you gotta shoot closer. What are you doing? Come on, aim a little better. There we go. That is absolutely ridiculous. Cheerleaders are so overpowered. You know what? For fun, let's throw a few good halflings in the mix as well and just see total destruction, because why not? All right, well, here comes the lag fest. Cheerleaders, let's do it here. Look how quickly these pumpkins reload. They're not even landing on the ground by the time the next one goes up. And the blast radius might be a bit more aggressive than the ordinary catapult. I don't know. It's hard to say. We'll have to compare them later on. Gotta say, clearly with some cheerleaders in the mix, though, this thing does a really good job at taking out a ridiculous amount of people. Now, I wonder if the bounce again... Oh, it does affect it again. So it does have a double bounce explosive effect. So if you had a lot of units kind of like right now and this thing was bouncing all over the place, this would be a really good strategy. I don't know if it's going to be able to take out all these things, but look at the amount of just exploding pumpkins everywhere in the back here. That's absolutely hilarious. So that would be, yeah, really good at dealing with some distant enemies in the back. If you can aim your pumpkin right, you might be able to get a couple hits off with just one shot. It's looking like they are going to win this battle as well. I got to be honest, I didn't expect that. Even with cheerleaders, this is a lot of units to deal with. And yeah, we got it done. All right, and just for fun, I thought we'd try the catapult against the pumpkin catapult. Now, they're the exact same price, so I'm thinking it is just a reskin. I forget if these things do a blast radius or not. I'm pretty sure, yeah, they do the exact same thing. So yeah, that's just a reskin of an old unit. Nothing wrong with that. But yeah, it's nothing new aside from looking really, really cool. All right, and moving on to the other map. Obviously, we have the Dynasty map that has been reskinned for Halloween. And obviously, a lot of work went into this map. So props to Landfall once again for going above and beyond for simple Halloween updates. So yeah, we got twisted trees everywhere. All the creepy things you expect from Halloween. Pumpkins, candles, and cobwebs. And yeah, with this other map, we obviously have two more units to check out. We have the Swordcasters here. This unit looks absolutely horrifying, so I'm assuming we have animated swords because its hands are locked in place as well as its face, it looks like. So I put these guys up against Jarls as well as some Brawlers here. So yeah, we'll see how these guys can do. I think it's pretty fair. Yeah, 2990 versus 3000. All right. I have no idea what all these guys do, but obviously these guys are some sort of spiritual beings. I'm thinking these swords will probably just start pointing outwards and spinning. Oh, or that. Oh my God, it shoots the swords. That is so cool. Unfortunately, this is like the worst unit to deal with because it has a shield. There we go. Now we got to get those Jarls down real quick. Oh my God, that is sick. These new units, man, this might be the coolest faction yet because each unit has its own unique playstyle, and it's totally different. Now, can Jarls get in range? They got lots of HP, but I don't know if it's going to be enough. That Jarl, he's still alive. He can't walk, though, because of the weight of his swords inside his torso right now. These guys can't get in range either. So I don't know if these swords are doing much damage, but they are really good at keeping the enemy at bay. Look at this poor guy. He's got a shield of the defender in front of him, which is keeping him somewhat safe. It's not going to be enough, though, I don't think. What happened to the other swordcaster? I don't even know how the other two died, but obviously the swordcasters absolutely dominated that. Let's try them against a few ice giants just to give them another chance here, because I want to see how fast these things shoot. Oh my God. How did they hurt themselves? They killed themselves. I'm gonna need a replay on that situation. Oh, it's because these swords are actually shooting from behind them. They're going so quickly that I guess he got in the way and the swords hit his face. Did it do it again? No, he's this one still somehow okay. I don't know how the other one. Yeah, there we go. He actually hit himself again. Look at this. They get buffed so hard, they actually kill themselves from the damage output of their own abilities. That's amazing. And finally, we have the Reapers. Now, I've seen this back thing on mods before. Now I know where those came from. We had the Reaper unit hidden in the files, clearly. But yes, this unit should be pretty interesting. It's got a giant scythe of death. And I put them up against some of my favorite boss units. So yeah, we got the Monkey King, the King, the new Pirate Queen, as well as the Viking Longship. I think, well, it should be a pretty close fight. I don't know how good these Reapers are, though, but I'm interested to see what they actually do. So here we go, some really powerful units battling each other. I was thinking they would jump in. It looks like they're just going to slowly walk in. Monkey King coming in for the hit, but the Scythe Bros, oh my god. What does that do? What the heck did that do? All right, well, it clearly has got a pretty major pushback. That didn't last long at all. Oh, I think the damage output of this unit is going to be crazy. Is this guy possessed? He's like stuck in the air. Is the tentacles grabbing them? I think the tentacles are technically grabbing them. Oh my god, that is a horrifying unit. Redhead, no problem at all. Okay, I want to see that against not necessarily strong units, but lots of little units. Let's go for Hoplite. It's a good all-around unit. One of my favorite units in the game, actually, if you're looking for just sheer damage output for price. So we're going to try a crap load of them, because I think it grabs the little units, and that was amazing to see. All right, here we go again. All aboard the spooky train, and yes, it does grab them. Oh my god. This faction is officially the coolest faction ever. I mean, just these new mechanics, they're literally ripping them upwards and holding them in their tentacles or whatever these things are. And I'm assuming it slowly kills them. Man, this is a force to be reckoned with. Like, look it, no problem at all. These guys don't die. Let's see if one can do it, just out of curiosity. So obviously, probably the weakness to this unit is range. They also use their scythe, as you can see. While grabbing the unit, but look at that. One swipe takes out pretty much anything it can reach. Bam! Done! Ridiculous. How much was that? It was 2,500 versus 12,000. That might be the most powerful unit in the game. And just to see what buffing it does, it probably just attacks faster, but you never know. Maybe we have a Reaper Tornado or something. Yeah, doesn't look like it does much with this unit. I mean, it's already overpowered to begin with. And there we go. They're all dead. I love this unit. I mean, that's what a Reaper should be. Just death walking right at your face. So with the update as well, we obviously have the spooky campaign. And I thought this would be just a really small campaign. But actually, it's about the same size as the rest of the campaigns in the game. So yeah, there is so much content with this new update. We'll try a couple of these just to try and fight against these units because I think it would be really fun. Obviously, we got the Skeleton Warriors right now, which were a pretty easy unit to deal with. I'm going to try and use the Pirate Faction for the most of this. Now, we only got 1,800 to deal with for right now, so I'm thinking Bomb Throwers would be really good against these guys. And if we want to try and stay in range here, so let's do some Blunderbusses in the back. Good defensive unit. Dude, are you okay? And then a flintlock in the middle for good luck. All right, let's see if range can do it here. Oh, we're gonna have to get lucky with those bombs. Keep them coming. Oh man, I forgot that these guys actually fall over due to their own attacks. Now they do get scared, but that's not necessarily a detriment with this unit. It would actually push it back a little bit and keep them at bay, which is exactly what you want to do with a range-based versus a melee unit. It's looking pretty good right now. 2-for-1 there. Did you see that? Yeah, these guys just don't have the defense, and there we go. I like that they just explode into bones. That is so perfect. Ooh, look at this. We're being surrounded now. I love this new update that allows you to create... Is that like a skull, or is that supposed to be a perfect circle? It's probably a perfect circle, actually. But yes, we're going to have to get a unit that's good at being surrounded. We have 4,000. I'm immediately going to Renaissance and using the Da Vinci tank. I mean, this is just obviously what this is made for. So there we go. Goodbye, you little jerks, hopefully. Da Vinci, stay alive in there, buddy. Okay, and we got defeated. So, I thought that would be it, considering we had 4 grand and the Da Vinci tank's 4 grand. But those archers, man. Let's see if the Monkey Brothers can do it. 2 Monkey Kings, just because they might have a hard time hitting these guys and scaring them. And I've always liked the Monkey King, man. He's actually one of the best bosses I've seen, especially for the campaigns, because he doesn't get hit very much at all. But still, this is a lot of units to deal with, so I don't know if he's going to survive it. It's going to take a little bit of luck here. How's he doing over here? They're actually still both alive, so that's a good sign. And this might have been the secret here. The Monkey King. Oh, he got hit there. He's on fire, that's for sure. What do we got left? 1 archer over here? No, don't jump down there. Please don't jump off the cliff. Okay, come on. Get back up. Get back up. Okay, he did not fall down. Thankfully, that archer missed as well. Looks like we still have the other Monkey King alive as well. And yeah, we totally got this, I think. Ooh. What is... Oh, okay. So that was just the Monkey King's animation. All right, we got Candle Bros. Let's try some Jousters here. I don't know if they'll work well or not. I haven't really used much of the Jousters. And then we're going to have some Musketeers in the back. See if that works. I have no idea. Ooh, did you see that shot, though? All right. Jousters, I mean, you guys are actually doing pretty good here, it looks like. So this totally worked. Holy crap! All right, I got to use the Jousters more often. All right, guys, and I think that's a good first look at the new Halloween update. So I hope you guys enjoy checking out this new awesome faction. I gotta say, it's probably one of my favorite factions just because each unit is so unique and a lot of them have really cool new mechanics to play with. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this. I hope you have a very happy Halloween. Now, I do have another episode coming out today. So yeah, we're gonna have 2 Halloween-themed episodes. Be on the lookout for that. And yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this. Thank you guys so much for watching and liking, and I'll see you in the next one.